Good afternoon, YouTube. These are Arris cable modem batteries. They're like the backup batteries that go into your cable modems, or I imagine these might also go into the voice over internet phone adapters. So yeah, I picked up a bunch of these. They come with two different types of cells. They're both LGs. I think these are the newer version, LGDA531865. The other ones are these darker blue cells, which I think these are an older model. So these are the older ones, LGCAS31. So these are set up with four parallel cells to get 8800 milliamp hours and then 8.4 volts. So two series, four parallel. We've been processing a bunch of these, and you get a mix of these newer cells and the older ones, and they've all been testing out between 3300 and 3800 milliamp hours, and that's the pair. So I'm keeping these paired up, and I'm also only testing them to 4 volts. So when I say 3800, that's for the pair, just to be clear. So let me show you how I open these things up. One thing I've done is left this out in the sun, and you leave this side up in the sun for a little while because there's a bunch of adhesive in here, and I'll show you that when I get in there. But let's try to crack one of these open, and we'll take a look inside. Okay, so here's where I crack these cells open. So I've seen some videos online of using a four-sided scraper blade. I didn't have one of those, but I have one of these two-sided blades. You can see how this blade only sticks out a little bit, so it can't go in very far, like if you were using a chisel or knife or something. And then what I have here, since this is on a handle, I have a piece of steel here to support this end, and then I line that blade up on the crack. So you put the smooth side up and give it a pop or two. So you can see that's why you want the blade to be not very long, because if it does go in, there we go. That's what I look for, is you got to get this end to split. And then I'll flip it around, and there we go. And then usually flip it over and just pop the other side here. You're not trying to crush it, you're just trying to crack the seam there, and then there we go. Pop those open. I'll get a couple more of these done, and then we'll go about getting the back side off. Okay, and this is the reason you want to leave this side up, because this is the side that's glued in. So you can see this side came out clean because there's nothing holding the cells in. But you can see here, that is solid. So this is a stiff bent putty knife, 1 1/8 inch wide. You don't want it the full width of the cell because you don't want a short here. What you're trying to do is you have to get that glue cut away. You'll see when I get them open here. So you just kind of want to take your putty knife here. And what I've done is I put a slight bevel on there. It's not sharp, but just to take it down so it's not blunt. And then I also rounded off the corners just a little bit so I don't tear the heat shrink on the cells as much. And you just want to work the blade down. Now this one I have to be a little careful because I cracked the case right there, and you run the risk of coming out of the cell into your hand there. But you can see I just push down. So the first time I just want to slice down there and get everything sliced on this face, and then I come back here and I go all the way to the bottom, and then I just pry up a little bit. You don't want to do it all in one shot because you might accidentally slip and then you'll tear the heat shrink. So you just kind of loosen it up. And then usually the second time around, if you listen, it'll start to crack right like that. And there you go. And there you can see all the glue or adhesive. This is kind of a rubbery adhesive. Not sure what this is, if it's a silicone rubber or something. It doesn't melt, but if you heat it up in the sun, it'll soften up quite a bit. because you have to get these blobs of adhesive loosened up. These older ones tend to be much worse. So again, I have to be careful on this one. There's a crack right there. So usually if there's a crack, I'll put it down on a surface. So in case it slips out, I won't jam my hand with this thing. There we go. So then this side is okay because it's intact. You just want to slide it down. You're kind of just slicing that adhesive. Usually just go down once and just kind of loosen things up a little bit and then come back and it's almost there. Like I said, these earlier packs, I think they use like twice as much glue in there. Wow, this one is like really in there. But that's why you need this bent blade so you can get around the corner a little bit. Just kind of work your way in. And you can see how much more glue is on the dark cells than on the lighter ones. They really laid it in there. Let me get through the rest of these here. I'll get them cracked open and then we'll continue processing these. Okay, now for the next step, what I like to do is cut off all the circuit boards. So these are the battery management boards. They have four wires hooked up and you got to cut them one at a time because these are the sense leads. The black and red are the power and then the white and yellow sense the voltage on each end. So cut one wire at a time and then clean off a little bit of this black stuff. Like I get rid of anything that's going to interfere with my cell holders. So like that blob there would definitely be in the way. Get all the tape off. So I get the ends. And then here in the center, you got to get these insulators off. Get that tape there. Sometimes this tape in the middle is underneath the glue. That can be a little hard to get up. But it clears off the batteries so they fit in my cell holders. So that I guess there's a positive side to that. Yeah, there's two pieces of tape on this side. So you gotta pop that one off and that one. And now you can fold it open. And this is where you can see how the cells are connected. So you've got four positives, four negatives all in parallel. And then the two ends are hooked up there and there. So you can see right here, you've got 8.4 volts. And now the trick is you got to separate these two. I use a pair of scissors like this and do not cut all the way across. I just come in from this side, give a quick snip, and then turn it around and give it another snip. So then I take a razor blade and just give that a slit there. So that one had been torn, like that insulator is torn there. So just give that guy a slit. Now you can spread these apart right there, and I take out these little spacers, and then now I get the scissors again, and because my cell holders are set up for pairs, I want to keep this pair and this pair intact. They're attached on that side, so I'm just going to come down here. You want to cut all the way through. Do one single cut, because if you stop and try to restart, you'll get a sliver here on the metal that you've left. And then it's just a matter of cleaning these up. So I like to get these when I'm done, they're ready to go into the cell holders. Of course, I'm going to do all the testing on them, but I want to finish up all the cleanup here right now. I cut that balance cable off. I fold that over so it's ready to solder to. Because I have to keep it so the cells go into my cell holder again. So that's the important thing I found, was do all of this now so you don't have to come back and do any of this after you've tested everything and you're putting things back together. So now this one, there's nothing to cut off. I just fold that over, and then here I like to cut that little bit off just so there's no sharp edges there, and it also fits into the cell holder easier. And then here's another one, just fold over. And then this one, you've got to cut off the black on this side. And you've got to cut that little tab off there. And let's see, this one's got a yellow. You got to cut that off. And then I like to just flatten that down so this gets folded over. And then this one, there's a little tab on the end, trim that off. And then at the end, I take a screwdriver handle and I just tap all these down smooth so that there's nothing sticking up here. This way, when I come to solder in my fuse wires, I can just solder right onto this center here. And there you go. So these are ready to go in. So as far as testing, what I'll do is measure the resting voltage of these. And if they're pretty similar, I put them in my charger. Got a 4-cell holder. I bring these four pairs up to 4 volts and then let them sit a week or so. Check the voltage, discharge test, and then I put them into another charger to bring them up to storage charge. So that's the cycle. So it'll take about a week to charge these up, rest them, discharge them, and then recharge them. And I'm doing all the charging on solar, so that kind of limits how many I can do, because I can only charge during the day. So yeah, anyway, 5 of those modem batteries gives me 20 pairs, and that's enough to actually build 2 battery modules. These are my cell holders right off the 3D printer, and I haven't separated them yet. So this would be bottom and top of one cell holder, but I'm just using them in the meantime to hold the tested cells. These have been charged, but not tested. Yeah, so here's a group of cells I've already tested. So you can see, like this one, 3.24 volts was the initial voltage, tested out at 3718. And I find that these groups of four will test out pretty similar, 3698. And then this one, 3669. And this one is 3675. So they're all within maybe 40, 50 milliamp hours. Yeah, if you have any feedback on processing these, or if you've had any experience, post up in the comments section below. And as always, thanks for watching.